गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास नाइन्थ। एज वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज कमर्शियल एंड नॉन कमर्शियल एक्टिविटीज, टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज। इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर व्हाट वी हैव लर्न अबाउट ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज, वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज दैट वर द कमर्शियल एंड नॉन कमर्शियल एक्टिविटीज। Okay, and the commercial activities were also divided in three parts, that was business, profession and employment. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about business in details. Okay, so our chapter name is business activities and today I'm going to give you the introduction about this chapter through the meaning of business and the characteristics of business. So let us discuss the meaning of business. Okay, so what is, as earlier we have already discussed that what is the meaning of business. So meaning of business is, the business is an economic activity, as we know that it is an economic activity. Why it is economic activity? Because the main motive of business to earn money, to acquire wealth. So the activities which are used to do to earn money, to acquire wealth, that are considered as commercial activities, means economic activity. So business is also an economic activity. Okay, so business is an economic activity. It involves sales, exchange of goods and services to earn money. Business mein kya kya cheeze included hoti hain? Pehli to sales, exchange for what? Exchange of goods and services. So exchange of goods and services. Everyone please underline these points. These are the keywords of your meaning, that these, a business is an economic activity, underline economic activity. Business, it involves sales, exchange of goods and services to earn money. Okay, sale, exchange of goods and services to what? To earn money. Okay, so to satisfy the human wants rather than personal use. Suppose I am cooking food at my home. Okay, so it will be considered as business? No, it will not be considered as business, because I am not doing it for all. I am doing it for my family. I am not earning money for that. Okay, but if I am preparing food in a restaurant or to sell that food, then it will be considered as business, because by selling the food, what I'll get? I'll get money. I will earn profit. Okay, so goods and services are provided to satisfy the human wants rather than for personal use. Okay, so now the next line is, business is an occupation and it comprises a wide range of activities. Now what is the meaning of wide range of activities? Everybody must be thinking that what is the meaning of wide range of activities. So let me tell you, jaise humne padha that business is an economic activity, usme kya kya include hota hai, sale include hota hai, exchange of goods and services to earn money. Ab you think this thing, that if you are selling something, if any businessman is selling something, so that product is coming from where? Okay, it must be producing somewhere. It must be someone is producing that goods which we are purchasing and we are selling that. Okay, so why it is called that business is an occupation and it comprises a wide range of activities? Because this is the business. Business is sum total of all those activities. Okay, business is a sum total of all those activities. The keyword is sum total of all those activities by which desirable things are extracted from the nature. Sum total of all those activities by which desirable things are extracted. Underline this word also. It's a keyword. Extracted from nature. transform and processed by men and machine. Okay, carry place to place, carry place to place is stored through place in the hand of those who are willing to pay. Okay, children. Now how can we say that this is the business activity is sum total of all those activities where the desirable thing are extracted from the nature, it will be converted into it will be processed, it will be converted into finished goods by men and machinery, and then it will be carried to place, then it will be stored also, and then it will be given to the hand of those people who are desirable to pay for that. Matlab, ab ek example aapko de rahi hu. Suppose aap furniture bech rahe ho, theek hai, aapka furniture ka showroom hai, you are not a manufacturer, you are purchasing that furniture from somewhere. Okay, so for that furniture, you are purchasing that furniture from somewhere, maybe that person is a manufacturer of that furniture. Okay, so that manufacturer, those who are manufacturing the things, see where they are getting that furniture. They are extracting the wood from the nature. Aayi baat samajh mein? Wood is what? It's a natural thing. And by here, what is their desirable thing? Desirable thing is wood, because by wood, wood will be transformed into and processed by man and machine, and it will be converted into furniture, and then it will be sale out. Okay, so by which desirable thing extracted from the nature? The wood will be extracted from the nature, then it will be processed, it will be transformed, उसे काटा जाएगा, छीलन होगी, जो भी चीजें होंगी वो प्रोसेसिंग होगी, किसके थ्रू होगी? लेबर्स लगेंगे, लेबर्स लगेंगे और मशीन, बाय थ्रू मशीन्स. तो उसको कन्वर्ट किया जाएगा, उसके बाद जब फिनिश गुड्स बन जाएगा, जब फिनिश हो जाएगा गुड्स, तो उसको कैरी कहाँ करके कहाँ ले जाया जाएगा? जो मैन्युफैक्चरर होगा वो कैरी करके किसके पास ले जाएगा? जो बिजनेसमैन होगा, ठीक है, तो किसके थ्रू? ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के थ्रू. ओके, किसके थ्रू? ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के थ्रू. किसके पास? बिजनेसमैन के पास. ओके, बिजनेसमैन के पास किसके थ्रू लेके जाएगा? ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के थ्रू. प्लेस टू प्लेस स्टोर. सपोज यू आर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग समथिंग. ओके, सो ये जो लकड़ी का है, क्या एक दिन में उसका सारा सामान बिक जाएगा? नहीं. एक दिन में क्या सारी लकड़ी का बन जाएगा? नहीं. तो क्या स्टोर करके सामान रखने की जगह? बाय वेयर स्टोर्स एंड वेयर हाउसेस. सो द थिंग, द मटीरियल, द गुड्स, वेयर द गुड्स विल बी स्टोर थ्रू प्लेस. प्लेस वेयर? वेयर हाउसेस. सो गुड्स विल बी प्लेस्ड थ्रू, स्टोर थ्रू वेयर हाउसेस. ओके, एंड देन आफ्टर दैट इट विल बी कैरीड और इट विल बी हैंड ओवर टू दोज पर्सन हु आर विलिंग टू पे फॉर दैट. मतलब उन पर्सन को वो प्रोवाइड किया जाएगा, उन कंज्यूमर को वो प्रोवाइड किया जाएगा जिस जो उसके लिए दे आर विलिंग, जो अपनी स्वेच्छा से उसके लिए पे करना चाहते हैं, या फिर जो अपनी स्वेच्छा से उस चीज को खरीदना चाहते हैं. Hopefully this thing is clear. I am repeating again, the business is a wider term. Why it is called a wider term? That because it is a sum total of those activities by which the desirable things are extracted from the nature, they transform and processed by men and machines, and then placed to place, placed in place to through transportation, and then placed stored through place in the hand of those who are willing to pay for that. Okay, so hopefully this thing is clear. Now we are saying that how we have learned that business profession and employment also. So how business is different from other commercial activities that were profession and employment. So let me tell you, beta, that which are profession. Professions are those activities, that profession is an occupation which requiring a special knowledge, as we have already learned. But for business, there is not necessary to acquire any special knowledge. Okay. In business, what we are getting? We are getting profit. And in profession, the professional person is getting fees for that. And if we talk about employees, so employment is an occupation where a person or employee work under their employer. Okay. And for that, they got wages or salary. So this is meaning of business activities, that business is an economic activity which involves sale, exchange of goods and services to earn money. Goods and services are provided to satisfy human wants rather than personal use. Okay, business is an occupation and it is comprises a wide range of activities. Why it is called wide range of activities? Because it is the sum total of those activities where desirable things are extracted from the nature, extracted from the nature, converted into finished goods and provided to the ultimate consumer. Okay, hopefully this much you have understood clearly. Now we will move to our next point, that is characteristics of business. We are going to discuss the characteristics of business activities. Okay, in previous video I have taught you about the business, the meaning of business, and the wider, how the business is wider than any other activity. Okay, now in this video we are going to discuss the characteristics of business activities. So in the characteristics of business activities, the first activity is sale, transfer or exchange. This is the first characteristics of business activities, that is sale, transfer or exchange. The meaning that sale, transfer or exchange is the characteristics of business, that means all the business activities involve sale, transfer or exchange of goods and services. Okay, and for what? For some consideration. What is the meaning of the consideration over here? Consideration means kisi cheez ke badle mein. Consideration kya? Kis cheez ki consideration mein? Money. Okay, so all the business activities involve sale, exchange of goods and services for some consideration. Consideration matlab to earn. Kisi cheez ke badle mein. Kiske badle mein? Paise ke badle mein. Theek hai? Buying and selling of goods or services for a price is the essence of business. It is an essence of business. Why it is an essence of business? Because if profit is not there, if we are not getting money by doing any business, if we are doing any business and we are not getting profit, so is it called business? Business is what? Business is an economic activity which involves sale, exchange or transfer of goods and services for what? For profit motive, for earn money to acquire wealth. So if there is no sale, if there is no exchange, if there is no transfer of goods, then it will not be considered as business activity. So जैसे मैंने आपको एक example बताया था, suppose I am cooking food at my home for my family, I am not getting any kind of money for that. Okay, so it is not considered as business. Here sale I have done? No. Exchange of goods has been done? No. I have acquired any wealth? I have acquired any profit? I have earned money? No. But if I am selling I am cooking food and I am selling to the different restaurant, or I am giving tiffin service. Okay, so I am giving tiffin service, so in that consideration I am getting money for that. I am selling that thing. So sale should be there, exchange of goods should be there, exchange of goods and services, and for some consideration means to acquire money. Okay, to money, to get money. Okay, so what the business? The business, all business activities, they involve sale or transfer or exchange of goods in some consideration. And what is the essence of business? The price which we get after selling. Okay, so this is the sale, transfer or exchange. Now our second point is dealing in goods and services. Now what is the meaning of dealing in goods and services? Why it is concerned as the dealing in goods and services? It is characteristics of business. Dealing in goods and services means every business enterprise produces goods or buy goods, and they buy goods to sell that goods. Okay, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था कि अगर suppose या तो हम चीज manufacture करें वो और या फिर हम कहीं से खरीद के लाएं बेचने के लिए, ठीक है? तो so every business enterprises they produces goods or they buy goods to sell, to goods and to provide the goods and services, to selling them to others. Okay, so here the point is clear how the dealing in goods and services, every businessman and or every enterprises they produces goods or they buy goods from others. Theek hai, they buy goods from others to sell to the consumer. Okay, their goods can be two types, that is goods, producer goods and consumer goods. Consumer goods are directly consumed by the consumer, the ultimate users, or the producer goods are those goods by though the consumer goods will be made. Okay, so these are the difference between consumer goods and producer goods. Okay, now our third point is regular dealing. The third characteristic is regular dealing. अब regular dealing का क्या मतलब है? Regular means which is regular in nature, which is recurring in nature. Now what is recurring? Recurring means जो बार बार हो, ठीक है? जो कई बार हो, जो रोज हो, that is recurring nature. So business involve a series of dealings. The series of dealings should be in means present in the business activities. Okay, a single transactions cannot be considered as business activity. See, suppose papa ka scooter hai, papa ne bech diya, unko dusra kharidna tha, unhone kya kiya, unhone usko bech diya, he has sell. Okay, usse unhe kya mila? Money mili, he has earned money. But it is regular in nature. क्या वो रोज स्कूटर बेचेंगे? क्या वो रोज जो है उससे पैसे कमाएंगे? नहीं, उन्होंने एक बार स्कूटर बेचा. नाउ सेकेंड अगर एस्पेक्ट देखें, सपोज आपके पापा का स्कूटर का बिजनेस है, सपोज शोरूम है स्कूटर का, ठीक है? तो क्या है वो? वहां पे तो ये काम रेगुलर बेसिस पे होता होगा, राइट? तो ये काम रेगुलर बेसिस पे हो रहा है, रोज उनके शोरूम से वो क्या कर रहे हैं? वो सेल कर रहे हैं, उस चीज को रेगुलर बेसिस पे कर रहे हैं. सो दैट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज बिजनेस. सो ओके, सो रेगुलर डीलिंग, सीरीज ऑफ डीलिंग शुड बी इन्वॉल्व इन बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज. अ सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन कैन नॉट बी कंसिडर्ड एज बिजनेस एक्टिविटी, दैट शुड बी रिकरिंग इन नेचर. ओके, सो होपफुली दिस पॉइंट इज ऑल्सो बी क्लियर टू यू ऑल. सो आर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज प्रॉफिट मोटिव. प्रॉफिट मोटिव मीन्स if we are a business is we can not say that business is a charity. Business is not a charity. Business is, the primary objective of the business should be profit, to earn profit, to acquire wealth. Okay, because we can say that if a business is not earning profit, that business cannot be stand for a long period of time. Okay, so the primary objective should be profit of any business. See, if profit will not be there, so expansion will not be there of the business, the growth will not be there of the business, right? It will not be there. And if the growth will not be there, then there is no use of business, because if we we are not earning the money, then there will be not expansion and not any growth, and there will be no need of doing any business, such kind of business, right? So if we talk about the profit motive, a business that does not earn profit, that cannot be, means you can say that will not be survive for a long period of time. Okay, so business, they must have sufficient profit, however earn profit by serving the society also, right? So business must serve the society as well as they should earn profit also. Okay, so now our next point is, that is fifth point, that is creation of utility. अच्छा, इसकी बात अगर राइट प्रॉफिट मोटिव की करें तो हम आपको एक चीज और बताएं. सपोज मैं अभी शूट कर रही हूँ, ठीक है, सपोज मैंने अभी प्रो कैमरा ले रखा है. सपोज मान लो अगर कोई मुझे बहुत प्रॉफिट, मैं अपनी एक कोचिंग क्लासेस चला रही हूँ, बहुत बड़ी कोचिंग क्लासेस चला रही हूँ जहां पे मैं ऑनलाइन क्लासेस दे रही हूँ, जस्ट एन एग्जाम्पल, ठीक है, अगर मुझे बहुत अच्छा प्रॉफिट हो रहा है, ठीक है, तो मैं क्या करूंगी, मैं एक और अच्छा कैमरा लूंगी, मैं अपना सेटअप थोड़ा और अच्छा बनाऊंगी, ठीक है, ताकि मेरी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस और प्रॉपर और बहुत अच्छे तरह से हो जाएं, ठीक है. हो सकता है मैं एक कैमरा मैन रख लूं, हो सकता है और बहुत सारी चीजें, हो सकता है कोई स्टूडियो में शूट करूं, है. तो इसका मतलब ये है कि अगर मैं ये सब चीजें कर रही हूं तो इन सब चीजों को लाने के लिए हमें क्या चीज की जरूरत पड़ेगी, पैसे की. और पैसा कैसे आएगा, प्रॉफिट के जरिए आएगा. प्रॉफिट जब हमारा बढ़ेगा तो हमारे बिजनेस की ग्रोथ होगी, एक्सपेंशन हो, एक्सपैंड करेंगे हम, अच्छे कैमरे से वीडियो बनाएंगे, अच्छे कैमरे, अच्छा सेटअप लगाएंगे ऑनलाइन क्लासेस के लिए, ठीक है. तो इसके लिए क्या एसेंशियल है, प्रॉफिट एसेंशियल है. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड दैट प्रॉफिट मोटिव इज ऑल्सो अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ बिजनेस एक्टिविटी. नाउ इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द फिफ्थ वन, इट्स क्रिएशन ऑफ यूटिलिटी. Okay, the creation of utility. What is, first of all, you should know that what is the meaning of utility. Utility means, so utility means whatever the satisfaction a particular individual is receiving by consuming a goods. ठीक है, utility is what? Utility is, it is, you know, in economic term also, in business term also, in commerce term also, it refers the total satisfaction received by a ultimate consumer by consuming a good or services. Okay, that is utility. Now if we talk about creation of utility, so business activities mein agar hum baat kare to business activity mein ek businessman jo hota hai, business, they make the goods more useful. They makes the good more useful to satisfy their customer. अब अगर कोई चीज आप खरीद रहे हो और suppose you are purchasing anything, you are purchasing, suppose आपने केक बनवाया, ठीक है, बहुत अच्छा, बहुत बढ़िया सा आपने सोचा था, ऑर्डर कर दिया है, बहुत अच्छा सा आएगा, लेकिन जब आप केक खाते हो तो आपको बिल्कुल अच्छा नहीं लगता है, तो क्या हुआ, यूटिलिटी उसकी जीरो हो गई, आपको बिल्कुल सेटिस्फेक्शन नहीं मिला. तो यूटिलिटी मीन्स द टोटल सेटिस्फेक्शन which a consumer is receiving by consuming a goods and services. Now if we talk about creation of utility, so a business, they makes business activity ki agar hum baat kare to profit hum tabhi kama payenge jab hamara customer jo hoga wo satisfy hoga hamare business, hamare goods or services se. So a business makes more goods more useful to satisfy the human wants. Uske liye wo kya kya karte hain, the businessman adds, क्या क्या चीजें add कर देते हैं, the time utility, place utility, form utility and position. Okay, they add the time utility, place utility, form utility and position utility. First we will talk about time utility. So what is time utility? You know people, the time utility means to avail the things, to avail the goods and services at the point of time when the goods is needed by the customer. Okay, so if we talk about, time utility means that providing the consumer his desired goods at the time when he required them. See children, the understanding the consumer's demand is very important, and it is very, very, very essential while making important decision about the business. Okay, it will help the company to decide when the increase of the production should be there, when we have to increase the production, when we have to get the sufficient inventory. Inventory means whatever the material, the stock, and when we to run their important marketing campaigns. So time utility means that to they should know, means they वो ये आठ चीजें करके रखते हैं, ये चीजें सोच के रखते हैं कि कौन सी चीजों का, कौन सा हमारा जो गुड्स हैं, जो हमारी सर्विसेज हैं, वो कंज्यूमर को किस समय पे चाहिए होंगी, ठीक है, कब हम उसको पूरा कर सकेंगे. क्योंकि देखिए क्या होता है, डिमांड्स, वेदर, दे वेरीड, वो वेरी करते हैं. जैसे अगर हम बात करें कि कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स, कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स की सबसे ज्यादा डिमांड कब होती है, गर्मियों में. आइसक्रीम की सबसे ज्यादा डिमांड कब होती है, तो गर्मियों में. जब डिमांड बढ़ती है तो हमें क्या करना पड़ता है, बिजनेसमैन को क्या करना होगा, प्रोडक्शन बढ़ाना पड़ेगा. उनको प्रोडक्शन बढ़ाना पड़ेगा, और प्रोडक्शन बढ़ाने के लिए उन्हें किस चीज की जरूरत होगी, सफिशियंट रॉ मटेरियल की जरूरत होगी. तो इस चीज को वो पहले से ही सोच कर रखते हैं, पहले से ही डिसाइड करके रखते हैं कि किस समय किस चीज की डिमांड हमें किस तरह से बढ़ेगी और किस तरह से हमें उसको फुलफिल करना है, ठीक है. तो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू टेक द डिसीजंस, बिकॉज यू नो, सपोज अगर अब स्वीट्स की बात हम करें, तो स्वीट्स की जो आपकी सेल है वो सबसे ज्यादा कब बढ़ती है. अब रोज तो नहीं हम लोग मिठाई मंगा मंगा के खाते हैं घर में, राइट. हम कब सबसे ज्यादा मिठाई खाते हैं, इन फेस्टिवल्स. सो फेस्टिवल में क्या होता है, उन्हें अपने क्योंकि गुड्स उनको बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में, बहुत बड़ी क्वांटिटी में प्रोवाइड करना होता है स्वीट्स को, तो क्या करते हैं, वो अपने पास सफिशियंट स्टोरेज स्टॉक कर रखते हैं, जिस चीज से वो उसको प्रोवाइड कर पाएंगे. हॉलीडेज के सीजन होते हैं जब, या फिर वेदर चेंजेस होते हैं, तो ये चीजें वेरी करती हैं. तो इस चीज के अकॉर्डिंग, टाइम के अकॉर्डिंग जो बिजनेसमैन होते हैं, वो अपने आप को प्रिपेयर करके रखते हैं कि किस समय कौन से गुड्स की कितनी जरूरत हमें पड़ने वाली है. ओके, बाय एडिंग द टाइम यूटिलिटी. नाउ इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द प्लेस यूटिलिटी, व्हाट इज प्लेस यूटिलिटी. सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द प्लेस यूटिलिटी, सो प्लेस यूटिलिटी क्या है बेटा, द प्लेस यूटिलिटी प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. How they are playing very important role? क्या होता है, कभी कभी जो decisions होते हैं consumer के, वो हमारी place पे भी depend करते हैं कि किसी जग किस जगह पे जाके, कौन सी जगह पे जाना consumer के लिए ज्यादा easy होगा, ठीक है. कभी कभी ये चीजें बहुत matter करती हैं. अगर बात की जाए कि the product, when the place utility, they plays a very important role. How they plays a very important role? Because sometimes क्या होता है, the decisions whether to buy the products or not is decided by the things, which is not decided by the things, that is decided by the location or availability of the product. कहां पे लोकेटेड है जहां से हमें सामान लाना है, और कहां पे कितनी अवेलेबिलिटी है उस चीज की. द इजिली द प्रोडक्ट इज अवेलेबल टू द कस्टमर, वहां पे बहुत बड़ी मतलब चांसेस होते हैं कंज्यूमर के ज्यादा मात्रा में सामान खरीदने के. ओके, सो अगर हम बात करें द कंपनीज, तो क्या करते हैं, तो बहुत सारी कंपनीज होती हैं, दे ट्राई देयर बेस्ट टू स्प्रेड देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल. डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल्स क्या होते हैं, हमारे जो एजेंट्स होते हैं, हमारे जो होलसेलर्स होते हैं, जो हमारे मैन्युफैक्चरर्स होते हैं, होलसेलर होते हैं, रिटेलर होते हैं, और जो एजेंट्स होते हैं, बहुत सारे होते हैं, ये अभी हम लोग आगे पढ़ेंगे. सो द कंपनीज दे ट्राई देयर बेस्ट टू स्प्रेड देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल एंड मेकिंग देयर प्रोडक्ट्स अवेलेबल टू द अल्टीमेट कंज्यूमर, ठीक है. इन एवरी पॉसिबल मैनर दे यूज टू ट्राई देयर बेस्ट टू स्प्रेड देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल. क्यों, क्योंकि द इजिली द प्रोडक्ट विल बी अवेलेबल टू द कस्टमर, दैट प्रोडक्ट सेलिंग विल बी इंक्रीज. ओके, सो द बिजनेस मैन एड्स देयर प्लेस यूटिलिटी ऑल्सो, बिकॉज द प्लेस यूटिलिटी दे प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. ओके, so hopefully these two points will be clear to you all, that sale transfer, dealing, regular profit motive and creation of utilities, two point, that is time utility and place utility. And in our next class we are going to discuss the next two point, that is form utility and possession utility. Till then, thank you so much, beta.